द फोर्थ क्वेश्चन. हियर इट इज गिवन, डिटरमाइन शियर फोर्स एंड बेंडिंग मोमेंट फॉर द बीम एज शोन इन फिगर. हियर वी हैव अ डायग्राम. We have to solve this question and draw shear force and bending moment diagrams. So now let us start solving this problem. As we can see in this question, from A to C, we have this kind of loading is called as uniformly varying load. And from C to D, we have uniformly distributed load. Now, whenever we have uniformly varying load, we have to treat it like a triangle, or you can say a right angle triangle, and we have to convert the intensity into the value of load. So first of all, I will say that in the solution of this question, I'll write down for UVL, that is uniformly varying load, I will be converting this UVL into point load. So point load will be equal to, since it is a right angle triangle, I have half into base into height. If I consider 18 kilonewton per meter as the base and height is 3 meter, so from this, I will be getting the answer as 27 kilonewton. It means I can replace this UVL with 27 kilonewton load, and this 27 kilonewton load will be acting at a distance of 1/3 of height from the base. Here, as we know, if we have right angle triangle where the two right angle sides, they are meeting, that point is called as the base. So from this base, the UVL is 27 kilonewton. It would be acting at 1/3 of this base. That is, at 1 meter from point A, we will be having 27 kilonewton load. That is the conversion of UVL into a point load. Now, as previously we had done, the first step is to calculate the support reactions. Here we have supports at point A and B, so we have to calculate RA and RB. So I'll write down the step number one. It is calculation of support reactions. Here I'll say that Fy is equal to 0, where upward forces are positive and downward forces negative. I can say that therefore, here I have RA plus RB minus 27, that is the UVL into point load. Next, 10 kilonewton is downward, so negative. 2 into this distance is 4, so it is 2 into 2, or 2 into 4, which is 8 in the downward direction. So minus 8 is equal to 0. Therefore, I will get RA plus RB equal to 45 kilonewton. This is my first equation. After this, I will say that summation of moments about point A is equal to 0. Here I will take clockwise moments positive and anti-clockwise moments negative. So therefore, if I am taking moment at point A, 27 kilonewton is at 1 meter distance and clockwise, so positive. So 27 into 1. Next, I have 10 kilonewton acting at 3 meters from A. So it is clockwise plus 10 into 3. Then I have this UDL, which would be 8 kilonewton acting at 2 meters. So if I take the moment here, that would be 8 into 5. Then I am left with RB. If I take the moment, RB is in anticlockwise direction. So it is minus RB into 5. Is equal to 0. So from this, if I calculate, I will be getting RB value as reaction at B, that comes out to be 19.4 kilonewton. Now I will say that put RB is equal to 19.4 kilonewton in equation number 1. So therefore, I will get RA value as 25.6. kilonewton. So here I have found RA and RB values. I will mark the values here. RA is 25.6. RB is equal to 19.4. So here I have my RA and RB values. After getting RA and RB values, I can see that step number 1 is over, and then I will go on to step number 2. In step 2, we have SF calculations. In SF calculations, first we will draw the sign convention. Upward force to the left and downward force to the right are positive. Downward force to the left and upward force to the right are negative. So therefore, I will be calculating SF. First, I will take the section to the right of A. If I am taking the section here, to the left of this section, I have 25.6 kilonewton, which is upward, so positive, plus 25.6. Then I will take the moment. First, I will take SF to the left of C and then to the right of C. If I am taking the section to the left of C, I will get this as SF at point C is equal to 25.6 minus 27. And the value is minus 1.4 kilonewton. That is, I have taken the section to the left of C. Now, if I take the section to the right of C, I will be getting this as minus 11.4 kilonewton. Then I will say that SF at point B, here also I will first take the section to the left of B and then to the right of B. So first, SF at point B, if I take the section to the left, then I have 25.6 minus 27 minus 10. This UDL, which is 2 into 2 downward, so negative, so minus 4, and this value comes out to be minus 15.4 kilonewton. After this, I will get another value of shear force at point B, and that will be, by taking the section to the right of B, In that, I will add RB, which is 19.4. So already I have minus 15.4. In that, I will be adding 19.4, and that gives me 4 kilonewton positive. Next, I am left with point D. So at point D, since it is overhanging, here the shear force would be 0. So SF at point D is equal to 0. So here I have all the shear force values. Based on these values, we can draw the SFD.